If you think of culture as an iceberg, only a small fraction of it is visible. Food, flags, and festivals, which are often talked about in schools, are the visible parts that we rightly celebrate. However, only when we look deeper, under the water, are we able to focus on the common values that connect us. In what seems to be an increasingly troubled world where social and political systems are being stretched, conflict within and between countries is at times heightened, while human rights are being ignored, this desire for peace grows ever stronger. Sometimes we see this common value emerging above the surface and becoming visible. For example, it is part of everyday language used when people greet one another and welcome the new day. In many parts of the Arab world and parts of South Asia, such as Bangladesh, for example, the greeting of Assalamu alaikum can be translated to peace be with you. The same is true as you walk through markets or into schools each morning in India or Nepal or Bhutan, where greetings of Namaste, which has not only a strong message of peace, the spirit in me greets the spirit in you, but also a physical gesture of palms brought together slowly at the heart to honor a special place in each of us. In Myanmar, greetings of Minglaba are met by bowing monks as they internalize a message where others add blessings to enhance the auspiciousness of the moment, or by giggling children as they scurry off to school. After many hours of hiking through the mountains of Lesotho, surrounded by the tranquility and rugged terrain, you are likely to meet a herd boy who has slept the night in a vacant rondavel and bellows out greetings of Lumela or Kotso, which means peace be with you. If you took a moment to research further the meanings behind shalom or the Korean greeting, you would find that they too have deeply seated connections to peace. However, they have become quick comments made to welcome, greet, and say hello, and in this overuse have likely lost the focus that was originally intended when put into practice hundreds or thousands of years ago. In highlighting this simple evidence of ingrained behavior, we can create the necessary shift in thinking needed to incorporate flexibility and open-mindedness in us all when looking at the globalization of the world.